girl. Now, I'm training her to be a Grand Prix horse. For a Grand Prix horse, I need a trot that I can passage from. I need a trot I can half pass in. Good girl. I need a trot I can extend in. I know she can go fast. What I've got to try and do is teach her to be able to push more forward, so when I take her more forward, she doesn't just run. Good girl. So every time I feel I get a little flat, a little half halt, get a little bit more height in the leg, then I'll edge her forward. Good. And I'll play, and I'll mould her. And it takes time. You know, this is not the end result, this is the start. Good. So every time I feel when she goes forward, she starts to run onto the hand, I'll bring her back, look for her to come more into the self-carriage, and then forward again. Now, throughout all of this, they have to stay supple around the leg. That's what's really important. Good. So if I close my left leg, sit back, press her over to the outside, she softens around the leg. Good girl. I never mind if a horse drifts out. I just never want it to drift in. Good. Okay, so within those transitions, good girl. What I'll do now is I'll start using some lateral work. So what I do is I build the connection up from behind. And also too, good girl, a little breather. Through doing the lateral work, what it allows you to do is keep pushing the horse up into the more competition frame without losing the back. Because obviously riding a horse more uphill, we have a tendency, if we're not careful, then to push the back away. Good girl. Okay, so I sit again. And you can see there from the rising when I sit. Good, good. Put a little bit more swing in through the body. Good. Now, don't get me wrong here. If she gets behind me, good girl, I'll make her quicker again. And then I'll bring her back again. She has to stay adaptable, supple. That's it. All right, so I'm going to bring large. I'm going to use the shoulder four. So a little less angle in the shoulder in. Start now, pushing it more around the leg. I'm going to create a shape in the hind leg. Allows the hind leg to swim more underneath the body. So then I can pick her up from the outside rein. Start to create more of an uphill tendency in the trot. If when I pick up, what we have to do is we have to, again, always thinking of it's twofold. One is that the fact that you can keep your horse reactive and supple. Two is how you do things, because therefore a horse learns through repetition, and we've got to think of what we're looking long term in the test, how we want to be able to pick the horse up and then ride into whatever the next movement may be. From your lower level test, where you might pick up from the walk and go into the trot, for your heading into your medium, advanced medium test, where you might pick up and go into a walk pirouette or a canter, up through to the special, Grand Prix special, where you have to pick up and go into the PR. So here she comes forward. If as I pick up I feel that they block, I flex her a little and I'll just squeeze her over from the inside leg, just get her soft around the leg, and then as she relaxes I'll come back straight. If she really blocked, drop behind me, I would give her a little kick and say, come on, you must stay forward, you must stay reactive. I'm not interested in her running off there. I just want a reminder that my leg does mean something. Good girl.